Hello everybody, welcome back, happy Tuesday. So on Tuesdays I share like a fun little like cooking tip or a short little hack, and today I'm going to teach you how to turn yogurt into homemade cream cheese. This is so cool, it was so much fun to make, and it is Paddington approved. Paddington is my little puppy, if you don't know, because when I finished making it and it was like in its cheese form, he was crying for it like he always cries for cream cheese. So if you know, if Paddington can tell, then I don't know, actually not Paddington likes everything, that's not a good test. Anyway, this recipe is so much fun, and it's like kind of like a fun way of like, if you want to like impress someone, like, look, I made homemade cheese. It tastes very, very similar to cream cheese, like to real cream cheese. It's just like a little bit lighter, so if you're spreading it on a bagel, if you add like a little bit of salt to it, it tastes so delicious. So let's get started. So first, what you want to do is line a mesh sieve with 2 layers of cheesecloth and then pop that into a bowl. Then place 1 cup of plain Greek yogurt into the liner and the strainer. And you can also add like flavorings or herbs if you like. I also added, so I like made it 2 little batches, and I added some basil, some chives, and some parsley to the cheese or the yogurt at this stage as well. But you can add maybe even like some dried nuts or some strawberry jam if you like flavored cream cheese. I hate flavored cream cheese with a passion. The herb one wasn't actually that bad, but like, can't do it. But if you like it, this is definitely the stage where you want to do it. You want to add everything before you place the yogurt in the strainer. Then you want to place the bowl, the sieve, and the cheesecloth, so that whole little contraption that you made, into the fridge for about 1 to 2 days, or until all the liquid has drained off. And you're going to see that there's some liquid in the bottom of the bowl. That's what the bowl is for, to catch that. If you're like me and you kind of like forget to check for like 3 or 4 days, that's okay. The cheese might look a little bit dry, but what I did to soften it out to like make it spreadable again is just pop it in the microwave for like 10 second intervals until it's nice and smooth and creamy, nice and smooth and creamy, and that it will like kind of rehydrate it a little bit and make it nice and creamy again. So don't worry if you forget about it, if you get busy, you can like go back in time a little. And yeah, so just like once the cheese is done, serve it up with some bagels or anything that you can use cream cheese in, and it tastes delicious. I think it's a lot also healthier than yogurt or than cream cheese from what I've read. So if you're looking for a lighter version, this is definitely something that you should try out. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't yet, please hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you get notified when I post my next video. I upload every day from Monday to Friday, so I have 5 recipes and videos coming for you guys every week. So if you love to cook, I definitely hope that you subscribe. And if you try this cheese out, please send me photos on Instagram or Twitter at PinkoBunny. I would love to see your photos. And like, let me know if you like added flavorings, or like even if you added maple syrup, that would taste good. Like maple syrup and like pecans or something, I think that would be really good. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow for another video.